Christmas tree. Have a happy holiday.
Hello friends, happy new year. This is my first video in 2018. As you can see, I still have Christmas tree. This is a video series called How to install a theme in Magento 2. In case you missed a first video where I explained different ways of installing Magento theme and covered couple of ways in previous videos, go check this video and you will find all the details. In this video, I'm going to cover theme installation via Magento Setup Wizard. I already purchased a theme on Magento Marketplace and I have it in my account, so I will be using this theme and install it with Magento 2.1. The theme I purchased only supports two versions of Magento, 2.0 and 2.1. That's why I installed Magento 2.1 in order to show how this theme can be installed via Setup Wizard. If you would like to install Magento on your local environment, I'm not going to cover it in this video. However, I have a video on how to install Magento 2 on your local environment. You can go ahead and check this video. While preparing this tutorial, I faced with lots of different local issues with my environment and I tried to fix all the issues. However, at the end, I decided to share a couple of issues because it's also important to understand that, for example, if I would like to use Magento Setup Wizard, there might be something you have to fix locally. So I will go and show you a couple of issues and we will fix it together. All right, I finished with my introduction. Let's actually go ahead and install a theme in Magento 2 using Magento Setup Wizard. Magento Setup Wizard is available under Magento Admin Panel and we can find it under Tools. However, in case we have virtual hosts configured to serve content from pub directory, you won't find this additional menu and I will show you how to enable it back. So we have to go to httpdvhost.conf file and for document root we have to remove /pub directory. Let's save this file and restart our Apache server. Also, in order to see additional menu, we have to clean cache. And refresh admin panel. So under system tools, we can see web setup wizard menu added. And from here, we can actually install our theme from Magento Marketplace. Let's first configure public and private keys. You can find public and private keys under your Magento admin account. I will just copy-paste mine and make sure to keep it private because once you have these keys, you have an opportunity to download all purchased and free extensions you have under your account. So keep it in secure place. So let's save config. And from now we can go to Component Manager. From this page we can see some information about Magento Marketplace account, like new updates, new purchases, last sync time, and our modules which are installed currently on our application. By clicking Install link we can see extensions grid, and basically this is a list of all extensions we can install for our Magento application.
I have one extension or theme purchased under my account. It's called Absolute Theme, and its component name is sysapp/absolute-meta-package. So once I configured public and private keys, I should find my purchased extensions here in the extensions grid. And if I will scroll to the bottom, I would see SysApp meta package, Magento 2 modules, and SIM. I will select all SysApp related components and click Install button. And on this page, basically this is a setup wizard for our components which we would like to install. It contains three steps. First one, Magento will check whether we are compatible, whether component which we're going to install is compatible with current Magento version. Then it will create backup and actual component installation. Let's go ahead and click Start Readiness Check. As we can see, we have all green. However, my local version of Cron is not configured, and Magento recommends to set up at least 2 GB of memory or setup wizard. First, I will set up Cron. And in order to do this, we have a page on Magento DevDocs called Configure the Magento Application. From this page, we can copy paste 3 lines of code, which we will add into our cron tab file. Basically, what we would need to change is a PHP executable path if it's different on local version. Magento directory path, and basically that's it. So crontab -e will show me empty cron file, and I will just copy and paste my prepared directories and passes. I will save this file, and also I would like to change memory limit so PHP -- ini will give me a list of configuration files, and basically I will change correct ini file and will change from 1024 to 2048. Then I will restart my Apache server. And let's go back and try to run our readiness check again. As we can see, we passed all checks, so we are ready to go to the next step. Usually it's recommended to backup all three options, code, media, and database. However, I will go ahead and uncheck code and media because I'm running out of box version of Magento without sample data. And I will click create backup. We have successfully created database backup, and we can go to the next step. And click install. As we can see, we have successfully installed a new theme called Absolute Theme. Let's go back to Setup Tool. Let's actually go to Admin Panel. My session has been expired. As we can see, we have new menu item, Module Manager. I would like to go to Content Design Configuration and select Global Theme, which is going to be a new theme which we just installed via Setup Wizard. It's called Absolute Theme. Let's save configuration. Next step would be to clean cache. So we will see changes on front end. Flush Magento cache. And let's navigate to our front end to see our applied theme. As we can see, we have been successfully installed a new theme called Absolute Theme using Setup Wizard, and it works just fine, and we can continue our work with other configuration settings for this theme.
And this is how we can install a theme in Magento using Magento Setup Wizard. So the takeaways from the video and from the tutorial what we just did are, first of all, that removing pub directory from serving request responses for your e-commerce website is not secure. However, Setup Wizard works only once you will remove this pub directory. For local environments, it's okay to use Magento root directory as a document root. However, on production environments, it's not secure, and I do not recommend to remove pub directory. Moreover, I would advise to check your production environment, whether you are serving your content via pub directory. Also, you have to configure cron in order to use Setup Wizard and install components, extensions, themes via Setup Wizard, because Setup is using cron in order to prepare all necessary configuration checks and store it into var directory into file, and this file will be used to check different PHP settings, environment settings, and dependencies prior to installing any components in our Magento 2 application. And finally, check PHP memory limit. For Magento Setup Wizard, it's recommended to use minimum 2 GB of memory just in case of some dependencies or some PHP processes which might take more than 2 GB, it's better to check it and to set it as your minimum setting in PHP. And after all, don't forget to restart your Apache server. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'm going to post new Magento 2 videos and tutorials on a regular basis, so you won't miss anything from this channel, and you will get some ideas, some motivation on developing with Magento 2. Stay tuned. Bye.